Arrays are a group of related items. You can create an array, declare it to be of a particular data type, and then store a number of items of that type in the array. You can easily add and remove items, and the array class provides a variety of methods for sorting arrays and for searching in an array. So they're a handy way to store a collection of related items. Well, think of the tasks you'll want to do with a collection of items. Add to it, remove from it, sort it. Well, you can easily sort an array of simple data types. So if you have an array of integers or strings, it's pretty straightforward to sort that. However, you can store anything you want in an array, including instances of classes. And by default, you can't sort an array of class instances. So if you have a customer class and you have an array of customers, you can't sort that by default. In order to sort an array, the items in the array must all be of the same type, and that type has to implement the iComparable interface and therefore provide a compareTo method. If the type in the array doesn't implement iComparable, or if you have multiple types in the array, you can type the code to sort, but the sort fails. Well, you might be wondering at this point, what does this have to do with generics? Well, it turns out that the introduction of generics provides you with a number of ways of getting around this issue. Well, what do you do if the class you're using doesn't implement iComparable? How do you sort instances of the class? Well, one thing you can do is create a class yourself that implements iComparer, and within that class provide a method named compare that performs the comparison. And then you can pass that to the sort method of the array and sort an array of classes. Let's go see how this works, and then we'll also see how you can use generic methods to make this work efficiently. Let's explore sorting arrays. First, I'm going to run the sort arrays of simple types demo. And in this example, we're first going to create an array called numbers, and that contains decimal values. There are three of them, 50.5, 10, 600. Now we want to sort this array. So we can do that quite easily by calling the sort method of the array class and passing in the array we want sorted. And when we do that, notice that numbers is now sorted. We can loop through each of the items in the array, and we can print and display that the array is now sorted. Let's create an array of strings. Call array.sort, pass in the name of the array, and now these strings are sorted. Finally, let's do the same thing with dates. We'll create an array of dates, today, 3 days from now, 4 days ago, and we'll sort that and display. So for simple data types, decimal, string, date, time, all we need to do is call the sort method of the array class. And that's because the decimal structure, the string class, and the date time structure in the .NET framework implement the iComparable interface. And therefore, these data types have built into them a compareTo method. And that's because the decimal structure, the string class, and the date time structure in the .NET framework all implement iComparable. And therefore, these data types provide a compareTo method. And the sort method of the array class uses the compareTo method to compare two values in the array to determine which goes before the other. So if your data type implements iComparable, then all you need to do to sort an array is call the sort method and pass in the array. Well, what happens if you're working with something that doesn't implement iComparable? Let's see an example of that. We're going to sort an array of files. We'll create a new instance of the directory info class, which is in the system.io namespace, and we'll pass to it C:\. So now DI represents the root directory. We can then call the getFiles method, and that returns an array of instances of the FileInfo class. So files is an array containing one element for each file in the root directory. Now we want to sort this. So we'll pass the name of the array into the array.sort method, and this code failed to compare two elements in the array. And the reason is the FileInfo class does not implement iComparable. And so the sort method doesn't know what to use to compare. A file class has many properties: name, size, date created. Which of these should the sort class use to compare files? It doesn't know, and we've provided no instructions, so this code fails. Let's see what we can do about this. I'm going to run the example sort with iComparer, and we'll see how we can sort arrays of files. Here, once again, I'll create an array of files, only now we'll pass to the sort method the name of the array and the name of a class. Let's look at this class, compareFileNames. We created this class, and it's in the comparers.vb file, and this class implements iComparer. The iComparer interface includes a compare method, and when we implement iComparer in this class, we agree to implement this compare method. Compare takes two parameters as objects and returns an integer. And then this code implements the compare method. Because we're comparing file names, we create two instances of the FileInfo class, and we cast the objects x and y to FileInfo. And at this point, we can compare names. File1.FullName, and this is a string, and so it has a compare to in it, because again, the string class does implement iComparable. So we can say file1.fullname.compareTo and pass in the name of a second file. And so at this point, back in the calling code, we pass a new instance of that class to array.sort. And now the array class knows to use the compare method in this class to compare two files. Let's set a breakpoint in here and come back and run this. So when compare is called, again, it passes in two objects. The first one is a file. And this file is autoexec.bat. These are instances of the FileInfo class, but they're passed in as objects. So in the next two lines of code, we'll cast file1 from an object to an instance of the FileInfo class, and we'll do the same thing with file2. Now, file1.fullname is autoexec.bat. Compare that to file2's full name, and we know that autoexec.bat comes before, and therefore we've sorted those two classes at this point. This gets done for each element in the array, and now the array of files is sorted. Autoexec is first, big.xml is the second one. Let's loop through the rest of these and see that. Here's the array of files sorted by name. And we can do this because we told the sort method to use this class, and in the compare method in this class, we specified compare based on file names. Well, what if we want to compare based on lengths? Well, then we create a new class. Compare file lengths is also in the comparers.vb file. It also implements iComparer, takes two objects, and again, we'll cast x and y to file info, and now we'll specify use the length property of the files, which is the size, to do comparisons. So now, we'll take the same array of files, and we'll sort it based on file lengths. Do the sort, display all those, and let's run through them all. There we go. And here's the list of files sorted by size. So what you've seen in this demo is that the array class has the ability to sort simple data types, as long as those data types implement iComparable. The sort method knows how to sort strings or integers or date time. And we saw that if you have an array of instances of a class that doesn't implement iComparable, then by default the sort method has no idea how to sort those class instances. So we saw that you could create classes that implement the iComparer interface, and then you provide a compare method, and in that code, you give the sort method of the array class instructions on how to sort an array. You just saw how to create a class that implements iComparer and use that to sort an array. And you may be asking yourself at this point, that's all very interesting, but what does this have to do with generics? Now we'll see how you can use generics to improve your sorting code. The class that implements iComparer is one way around the issue that the sort method of the array class can't sort types that don't implement iComparable. There's another technique you can use, and that's using a generic comparison. The way you do this is you create a method that does a comparison. And this method has two requirements. It has to accept two parameters of the same type, matching the type of data stored in the array, and it has to return an integer value representing the result of the comparison. A positive number if the first value is greater than the second, a zero if they're the same, and a negative number if the first value is less than the second. You then pass the address of that method to the sort method of the array class, and you don't need to implement iComparer. Generics also help when you're searching within an array. The indexOf method of the array class returns the index of the first occurrence of a value in an array. So if you have an array of 5 strings, you can call array.indexOf, pass in one of the strings, and it'll tell you the first time it finds that string in the array. This works fine for simple data types when it's clear what to be searching for, but it doesn't work well for complex data types. The indexOf method needs to know what it's looking for. So to work around this, you can create a method that defines the criteria that you want the indexOf method to use. You define the set of criteria in a method, and then you write code to determine whether an object meets those criteria. And that criteria is typically going to be, is this value found in the array? Then you can pass the address of that method to the findIndex method of the array class. Let's now see an example of using generic comparisons to sort arrays and generic predicates to search in an array. I'm running the sample application. Let's take a look now at how we can sort an array using a generic comparison. In the previous demo, we sorted an array of files. Let's recreate that array. This array files contains files that are in the root directory. And before, we sorted them by passing to the sort method an instance of a class, either compare file names or the class compare file lengths. And that class implemented the iComparer interface. You can also pass to an array a generic comparison. And the way you do that is you specify a method. So here, compare file names is a method contained in the comparers class. I'm going to pass the array and the address of that method. Let's go take a look at that method. This method, compareFileNames, takes two parameters, an instance of a FileInfo class and another instance of the FileInfo class, and then it compares the names on these classes. Let me set a breakpoint here, return to the code, and run this code. When we sort the array, we come into the compareFileNames method. File1 is an instance of the FileInfo class pointing to a file, and File2 is also an instance of the FileInfo class pointing to another file. We can then compare the names on those files and return the result. Let me remove this breakpoint, step out of here, finish the sort, and then display the results. Let's run down to here and display all of them. Here we go. Here's the list of files sorted by name. We're going to do something similar for sizes. The compare file lengths method again takes two instances of the FileInfo class as parameters and compares their size. Let's run down to here. And here are the files sorted by size. Well, that looks exactly like what we did in the previous demo. So what's the difference? In the previous demo, we created a class called compareFileNames, or compareFileLengths, and we implemented the iComparer interface and provided a compare method which takes as parameters objects. Then we had to cast those objects to instances of the FileInfo class, and then we could call the compareTo method on FullName. And we did something similar when we compared file lengths. A class that implements iComparer, the compare method takes objects. So because the compare method takes objects, we had to do the casting. We'll compare that with the compare file names method and the compare file lengths method. These are defined by the person who wrote the code to only take instances of the FileInfo class. And they're then defined to take instances of the FileInfo class, and we specify how to do the comparison. So this is a generic comparison. The generic comparison is a method that follows two rules. First, it accepts two parameters of the same type, in this case FileInfo, and that type matches the type of data stored in the array. And we have an array of instances of the FileInfo class. The second rule for a generic comparison is that it returns an integer value representing the comparison of the two parameters. And that's this code here. So we can avoid implementing iComparer, we can avoid implementing the compare method and taking in objects and casting them by more directly specifying the data type we're going to use and specifying how the comparison gets done. So this method, compareFileNames, as well as this method, compareFileLengths, is a generic comparison and can be passed to the sort method of the array class to sort an array. Now let's look at comparing another type of data. Let's create three instances of the customer class. The first customer gets a name, the second customer gets a name, and the third customer gets a name. And then we'll create an array of instances of the customer class. So this customer array has three customers in it: big industries, small industries, and tiny industries. Well, the customer class does not implement iComparable, and it doesn't at the moment implement iComparer either. But that's okay, because all we need to do is create a generic comparison. So also in the comparers class is a method called compareCustomerNames. And that method takes as parameters two instances of the customer class and then it performs a comparison based on the customer name. And therefore, we can pass that method to the sort method of the array class, and we can sort this array of customers by name. If we wanted to sort by some other property, such as region or total sales, then we could just create a different method in that comparers class, and therefore we can sort customers as many ways as we want. Let's now look at searching in an array. First, we'll run the findValuesInArrays method. Let's look at the code in the findInArray method. First, we'll create an array of strings with three values: Canna, Franistan, and Anna. Now, what we want to do is search for the string Jimmy. The indexOf method of the array class takes an array and a value and then tells us whether or not this value is found in the array. This should return a negative number because the string Jimmy is not in the array of strings. Well, this works fine for simple data types. This array of strings contains three strings, and the indexOf method knows how to find whether or not Jimmy is one of those strings. Well, what happens if we're not using simple data types in our array? We can use a generic predicate. So let's look at that. I'll press I and run the find with generic predicate example. Now, we're going to create an array of three customers. Big Industries, they're in Canada. Small Industries is in the US, and Tiny Industries is in the US. I'll now create an array containing these three customers. And now what I want to do is get a list of customers in the USA and customers who are not in the USA. And I want to do that by searching through the array. Well, the findIndex method of the array class needs to know what to go search on. There are a number of properties in the customer class. The findIndex method has no way of knowing that the information we're looking for is in the country property of the customer's class, so we have to provide it a way of knowing. And to do that, we'll use a generic predicate. A generic predicate is a method that defines a set of criteria and also contains the code to see if the criteria is true or not. So let's do this. Let's loop through the array. So here we're going to pass to the findIndex method the array, that's the first parameter, customers, and then the address of this generic predicate, which is the last parameter. Let's go look at this first. The generic predicate is the method isInUSA defined in the customer class. And that's really quite simple. It returns an integer, and that integer is true if the country property of the customer is USA. And while we're here, let's look at another method, isNotInUSA, which takes an instance of the customer class as a parameter and returns true if this customer is not in the USA. So the generic predicate is a method that defines a criteria, country is USA, country is not USA, and then returns the answer, true or false. So we're going to call the findIndex method of the array class, pass in customers, pass in as the second value an index, which starts off at 0. Let's call that. And the index is 1, indicating that we found a customer that is in the USA in position 1. That's position 1 in the array. So we can now write customers 1, which is the first customer, which is small. So this is the first customer in the US findIndex found. Now, we'll do that again, and this time we'll pass into findIndex 2, telling it to start with the next element in the array and see if the customer's in the US. Let's step into this. We're passing in here the next customer, which is Tiny Industries, which is in the USA. And therefore, this method's going to return true. So index is now 2. So the customer in position number 2 in the array is in the US, and we'll print that, Tiny Industries. We'll keep going until we're done looking in the array. Now, let's do it again, and this time look for customers not in the US. So we'll go in, we'll start at index 0. This customer is Big Industries, who are in Canada. And so this method returns true. The index is 0. This customer is in position 0. And we print the first customer not in the USA. And we'll keep doing that. The other two customers are in the US. They're obviously not in Canada. And so now what we've done is the first time through the array, we used the generic predicate is in USA to return the results of this simple question. Is the customer property for this customer equal to USA? If yes, then findIndex has found an element in the array that meets the criteria. We did that for customers in the US, then we did that for customers not in the US. So what you've seen in this demo is the use of generic comparisons, which are methods that meet two rules. They accept parameters of the same type, which is the same type in the array, and they return an integer value representing the results of comparing. And you can use the generic comparison to do a sort in an array. You don't need iComparable, and you don't need iCompare. All you need is a generic comparison. And you also saw using a generic predicate to search in an array. The generic predicate is just a method that defines a criteria and returns whether or not an element in the array meets that criteria.